Holiness, holiness, it's what I long for. Holiness, it's what I...
Hello, God's wonderful people. Welcome to Daily Rhema on AGTV. I continue with the series on emulating the exemplary holiness of Abraham. Genesis 17, verse number 1. God told Abraham, I'm the God Almighty. Follow me and be blameless. God was demanding righteousness, righteous living from Abraham. Now we are looking at the price he paid to achieve this exemplary holiness. In Genesis chapter 12, from verse 1 to 3, now the Lord said to Abram, go from your country and your kindred and your father's house to the land that I will show you, and I will make of you a great nation, and I will bless you and make your name great so that you will be a blessing. I will bless those who bless you, and him who dishonors you, I will curse. And in you, all the families of the earth shall be blessed. Hallelujah. Abraham achieved this exemplary holiness at a high cost. He was living in Ur of the Chaldees around Iraq, today's Iraq. And that place was largely an idolatrous area. They didn't know Yahweh, the God of Abraham. They were worshiping all kinds of idols. And God said, to be holy, to be righteous, live. In fact, the Hebrew word that translates holy is set apart, separation. So holiness is separating yourself from anything that is ungodly, unrighteous, worldly, carnal, sinful, anything that defiles soul, spirit, and body. So God demanded of Abraham, he says, leave your country. Number two, leave your family and go to a land that I will show you. Holiness is about separating yourself. Hallelujah. He was going to miss his country. Your country, your family stands for the place of comfort and familiarity. This was where he was born and raised. He was going to a place he had no idea of the geographical location. He didn't know how the place was, except that God said, I will make you great, I will bless you, I will prosper you, and that you shall be a channel of blessing. Hallelujah. Holiness is achieved at a high cost. He paid a mega price. Great sacrifice. He left his comfort zone. He left his place of familiarity. Change. All of us fear change because change comes with uncertainty. God says, go to a place I will show you. Leave everything you have. And remember, he couldn't carry everything he had possessed and achieve in Ur of the Chaldees. He was leaving everything he had ever acquired, everything he had ever owned, to go to a place he had no idea of. Holiness means sacrifice. Genesis 24, when God appeared to him and said, take your only son Isaac and go to a land and sacrifice him. Kill your son, give him to me. Guess what? Abraham obeyed. The reason why many people don't pursue holiness is because they feel the price to pay is too high. They feel that they cannot handle that mega sacrifice. Hallelujah. Child of God, tomorrow I'll be looking at the prize you will earn. P-R-I-Z-E. The reward of holiness. And you'll discover that the reward outweighs, is far more than the price you will pay. Hallelujah. In Hebrew 1, 9 to 11, the Bible says this about Jesus. It says, because you have loved righteousness and hated iniquity, the Lord thy God has elevated you above all. Holiness is loving righteousness and hating sin. The benefits, the prize, the reward is mind-boggling and mind-blowing. I encourage you to pay the price to be holy. Christ paid the price to be holy on the cross. He left his father's throne, everything, and came down. Today, he is highly exalted and at the right hand side of the Father. At the mention of the name Jesus, every knee bows and everything is subservient to Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. The price to pay for holiness is huge, huge. But guess what? The reward is 1 million times better, bigger, and far more than the price you pay, the sacrifice you make to attain or to achieve the righteousness of Abraham. Let me conclude by reading Genesis 17, verse number 1. What does the word of God say? It says, when Abraham was 99 years old, the Lord appeared to him and said, I am God Almighty. Walk before me and be blameless. God demands holiness from each one of us. I choose to emulate the exemplary holiness of Abraham. I pray you do same. Same time on AGTV, Daily Rhema comes your way. God bless you.